I'm Luc van den Brande. I was former minister-president of Flanders, Belgium for many years, and before minister of labor, and also president of the Unions Committee of the Regions. The first thing is that education plays an important role because it is about mindsets. Yeah, and even the best structures, and democracy is never fulfilled, it may not always lead to tolerance, to dialogue and to understanding. So the first point is the education and the mindset to see the other as an alter ego, as someone who is your brother or your sister. And this is one of the ways we have to overcome these conflicts as well. A second point is that the structures of the state or the region or the provinces, they have to be open for dialogue and give opportunities to meet each other and not just to see what are the differences, but to highlight what we have in common. So you cannot make it always with laws or a constitution or a regulation. It is about the implementation and the way you are using what is possible in our society. Well, we in Western Europe, in a large part of Europe, we were fighting each other for two or three centuries. In fact, it was terrible to see that a million of people were, in fact, not just affected, but even killed for religious differences in this era. So it can be a message that overlooking this long period, that finally we have to be clear on at least two things. The personal belief is a human right, is a fundamental right, and we have to preserve it because it is about the integrity of a person. The second point is that there has to be a separation of religion and state, whatever religion it may be. So we experienced bad experience over so many centuries. So I think it is the only way to, on the one hand, also in the public forum, it is for me clear that you have to admit what your personal beliefs and belongings are, but you have to be strict to make this separation. The church in our countries could not and cannot run the public sphere. And this is what we have to make clear to everyone. On the other hand, some ones are going even further to say that religion and belief is just something for your inner house. I think that for the capital, the social capital of a community, of a country, it is important that people are making clear what their opinion is. And the real meaning of pluralism is about what I call external pluralism. We have not to start with the point that people are different on religion and so on, so we have to hide what our conviction is. So I think it is a cross-fertilization to the community that people are emitting their opinion, but knowing that we have to respect each other's opinion and that you cannot say, I am the only one to be the right one. And this is not, what I may say, the human condition to the respect of each other. Of course, it is important to make clear at new in the educational field, because this is the starting point, that people know what also the history is, what is behind the conviction. We have to use the opportunity that there is a dimension in our actings in societies that can be an added value in terms of fundamental values, in terms of quality of life. As we all know, Turkey is at the forefront or in the center of the bridge between, well, may I say, not the Western world, because we have to be careful to go for categories, to speak in terms of the West, the East, the South, and so on. So we have to be careful on this point. But Turkey can obviously, overlooking studying the geography and looking to the neighbors, so many neighbors of Turkey, I think that the real role of Turkey can be to be a bridgehead to the one and the other, may I say, tradition and approaches of society. And so to be open, also to be open to the fundamental three pillars we have to assess. It's always the same. It is about human fundamental rights, because even, as I said, democracy is never achieved. When it is even a non-achieved democracy, you have to respect the personal fundamental rights of people and then the rule of law. So I think that overlooking the last period with important reforms, all the 8 or 9 reform packages in the country, but I am always saying it's not only the case for Turkey, that the way you are implementing it, and even more important, the culture to deal with it, is more important than just the implementation. So Turkey may play an important role in this issue.